put our box together, we're going to need the Martha Stewart scoreboard with the envelope thingamabobber. That's right, thingamabobber. And cardstock that is cut 12 by 12 cardstock that's going to, you're going to take an inch off so that it's 11 by 11. I'm going to take an inch off all the way around so that it's 11 by 11. See, 11 by 11. I'm going to, because of the all of this busyness going on, let me do it from this side so that it looks a little bit better. And then we're going to be scoring at 4 and 4.5 all the way around on all corners. You want to make sure that this corner is butted up against the side of the scoreboard. All right, 4 and then 4.5. Four and then 4.5. We go. Now you want to make sure that you crease all of the score lines real good. Now the next thing that we want to do is right between each corner, there's a little triangle that meets right there. We're going to cut that out all the way around. Here, 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 here. All right, so see, now we got all of our notches out, and now we're ready to put our box together. All right, so but before we put all of that together, we are going to put our, this is what we did, our cover, our box cover. And just so that I can see this bad boy, let me fold these edges in. That will make it a little bit more visible for me so I know where I'm putting it. Because I'm telling you, it's all, it's so busy I can hardly see these score lines. Alright, so I'm going to put some tape on the back. This is why I should have waited to put the flower on at the very end because of this tape. But let's see how I do. Thank you. All right. Let's see. What do I want to be? I want this to be my... I want this to be the top, so... Alright, I'm just going to eyeball this as much as I can. Alright. Now, while I got this out, these are going to be the sides of our box. And we are going to want to put... these are going to be the sides... this is the bottom of our box. So we want to put tape right here at this very corner, not where you have to be mindful of where these score lines are. We don't want to put it all the way down here. We only want to put it right here and along this edge. Same on this side, right here and along this edge. The bottom of our box, we have to be mindful again of the score lines. We want it here. And all along this edge right to here. All right, let's see if we can do that. Okay, that's that side. Okay, our bottom, again, right here. Okay. All right. Let's turn this over a little bit. Oh, you know what? I did this wrong. Hold on. This is the bottom of the box, so I'm just going to rub this off. Totally did it wrong. The good thing about the runner tape is that you can just rub it off. I love that. Not like glue, where if you've messed up, you messed up. All right, so it's actually the other side. So remember that. For the bottom part, you're just reversed. You have to turn it over. Same thing between those score lines. And the reason why we're doing this is because when we join the box together like this, there's tape here at the bottom that's only going to be this part, so we also need to adhere this up here. So you want to bring this over, bring in your box up. You want to make sure your edge hits the edge of that side. And then slip your hand inside and just kind of press against it so that you can get them to adhere together real good. Then on the other side, just kind of flip it in a little bit. Get this edge to the edge of where the score fold is. And put your hand in there. Now you will have a little tiny space right here. I just take some double-sided tape. I'm just going to cut a little piece off. Slip that in there. And I see my measurements off a little bit. There's an overhang, but we won't worry about that. And there is our box that you are going to put your cute little book in. Voila! Voila, you can then either tie a ribbon or put a little sticker to close it, or that soft, the small Velcro to close it. But anyway, there you go. Your art journal box and book. Thanks for watching.